Dear children, today I will explain a chapter Bachpan, which means childhood, from class 6 Vasant. In this chapter, the author Krishna Sobati has discussed the difference between her childhood and your childhood. Basically, she is discussing the changes which she has observed from her childhood to your childhood. She starts the conversation by telling you that at present her age is might be similar to your grandma's age. This way she is trying to tell you that there is one generation gap between you and her. Then she discusses about her dresses. She tells us that she used to wear very colorful dresses when she was a kid, like frocks, knickerbockers, and ethnic wears like lehenga, choli, etc. And she would decorate her hair with colored ribbon. Nowadays, our girls wear colored bobby pins and clips, etc. in her hair, but the writer used to decorate her hair with colored ribbons. Then she says, the most importantly, she mentions that in her time, children used to tuck their handkerchief with safety pin just above their front pocket. Children, you might find it funny, but it was in trend. Even my mother would tuck a handkerchief like this only, and I would feel that I am the smartest of all. I'm looking very smart wearing this ribbon. With this handkerchief. Next, she tells about her Sunday mornings. She tells that on Sunday morning, they had to wash their socks and polish their shoes. They would do that because they were not allowed to give them to the servants. And maybe their parents wanted them to become independent, and their parents wanted to do this stuff so that they can do their stuff on their own. They would apply polish to their shoes and rub it gently till their shoes are sparkling shine. She would enjoy this task thoroughly. Okay. Then she tells that your shoes are more comfortable than hers at that time, because whenever they would buy new shoes, they had to keep a ball of cotton with them to avoid injuries due to hard leather and stitching of shoes. Then she remembers that on Saturdays she had to drink castor oil, and she used to hate it like anything, and she would feel like vomiting just before a day, remembering that the next day she would have to drink this oil. Parents used to give her because they felt that this oil is good for health. Then she comes to her interests, and she tells us about the things which were available at her time. She tells us that nowadays children have radio, television, even we have computers also, and smartphones also, but at that time she had only gramophones to listen to the music. Children, you have cakes, pastries, pizzas, burgers, but she had patties, kachoris, samosas, etc. She had shahtoot, falsa, khaskhas sharbat, but not Coke and Pepsis. But she had Vimtos and lemonades also that time. Then she tells about restaurants they had that time, and the way she used to eat chocolates. She tells that they were allowed to buy one chocolate in a week only. I hope she used to brush after eating her chocolate at night. Children, when we eat chocolate at night and we don't brush, we get cavity in our teeth. So be careful. They had different fruit to enjoy, like kafal, kasmal, shahtoot, etc. And she would eat chestnut and powdered dry seeds of pomegranate, which is called anardanika churn in Hindi. And a very interesting thing, they used to eat that chana zor garam. Children, in my Hindi video, you can see how to make that puri of chana zor garam. How to sing chana zor garam. Babu melaya masedar chana zor garam. This song was very popular that time, and they also used to eat chana like this. Then she remembers small road, and she says that there was a shop where model of Kalka Mail was kept. And that time Kalka Mail was the fastest train. Okay. Then she talks about aeroplanes. She would rarely see aeroplanes in the sky, and she would think that it's a huge bird. Okay. Then she comes to her spectacles. She says that time wearing spectacles was not very common amongst children. And the doctor said that after wearing some time, you will get rid of this, but it never happened. Although her number reduced with time, and she says that I myself was responsible for this because I used to study under the lamp at night, but I would avoid studying at daytime. Daylight is good for our eyes, na? So that is why she says that I should have not done this. Okay. Then she says that her cousin would tease her for this. He would say that you look like a baboon, and he would say in a rhyming tone. Although she felt bad when he used to tease her, but she liked the rhyming scheme of that teasing. And then she says that finally I'm well adjusted with these specs, and I have started wearing caps. I have stopped wearing dupattas, and I find this kind of dress up with specs, caps and kurtis. She is more comfortable in this kind of dresses. So this is how she has explained her childhood. I hope you have understood the chapter, because I know children, there are many children who have Hindi as a second language and they are finding it difficult to understand. So this video is specially devoted to those children. Thank you so much. And after watching this, you can watch Hindi video also. Then you will understand in a better way. And try to do question answers. If you are not able to do, please do let me know in comment box. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.